So, dear students, we are going to study very important concept which is known as speed of approach and speed of separation. So, here we go. Speed of approach and speed of separation. Let us try to understand this concept with the help of this example. Here two particles are shown. These two particles are moving towards each other with speed 10 meter per second each. So speed of approach is 20 meter per second. The point is at this moment these two particles are coming close. Their separation is decreasing at a rate of 20 meter per second at this moment. So you got the point. What is speed of approach? Speed of approach is nothing but the rate at which separation between two particles decreases. That rate is known as speed of approach. And this way you've got the next point also. What is speed of separation? Speed of separation is the rate at which separation increases. Right? So you've got the complete point. Let us see it. What? The rate at which separation between two particles decreases is known as speed of approach, as we have got in this example. And absolutely similarly, the rate at which separation between two particles increases is known as speed of separation. It is very simple. Let us see it with the help of this figure, this example. The two particles are moving apart, away from each other like this, 10 meter per second, 10 meter per second. So at this given moment, they are moving away from each other at this rate, 20 meter per second. These examples are actually very simple, right? So let us move forward and let us try to understand. Let us see it in this way. What we have just studied, let us again see it in this way. It is quite similar figure. At certain moment, the particles A and B have velocities as indicated. Let us see this. So speed of approach is V1 plus V2. It is the same example. In this case, speed of separation is V1 plus V2. There it was numerical term 10 meter per second. Here it is V1 and V2 respectively. So now we are getting slowly what is speed of approach and what is speed of separation. Wait, please increase concentration. Slowly we are moving ahead. Now let us focus on this situation. This particle has velocity V1. This particle has velocity V2 like this. Now, dear students, focus. In this case, now it depends on the magnitude of V1 and magnitude of V2. Which one dominates? Which one is more? Let us see. If this velocity dominates over this velocity, then these two particles will be approaching. And then we can say it is case of speed of approach. And we can also declare, if V1 dominates over V2, we can also declare that speed of approach is V1 minus V2. Let us see it this way. If V2 dominates over V1, then we can say the particles will separate. And we can declare that speed of separation is what? V2 minus V1. And absolutely similarly, think, focus. If V1 is equal to V2, then these two particles will be moving. They will keep on moving. But the separation between the two will remain same. Right? So we can say that speed of approach is zero, speed of separation is zero, particles are neither approaching nor separating from each other, right? So you've got these points, very simple points. In this case, if V1 is greater than V2, speed of approach is what? V1 minus V2. At this moment, the particles are approaching each other because V1 dominates. And similarly, if V2 dominates, we've got this point. Then speed of separation, V2 minus V1. At this moment, the particles are separating from each other, right? And if V1 equals V2, speed of approach equal to speed of separation equal to 0, they are neither approaching nor separating from each other. right? So these points are very, very simple. Let us move forward. Dear students, this video may be a little fast. If it is a little fast, then please you can repeat it 2 times or maybe 3 times, because these concepts are very important. We are going to apply it in problems in coming videos. Dear students, focus on this figure. You're getting this figure, and you have read these lines also. This particle is fixed and this particle is moving on this circle with velocity v. The magnitude is v, and because it is moving on circle, so its direction would be changing as usual. Everyone, we need to decide whether it is case of speed of separation or speed of approach, and what will be the value of speed of approach or speed of separation, whichever is applicable. Right? You have read this. You are mentally attempting it. What will be the value of speed of approach in this case? Or maybe if it is case of speed of separation here, what would be value for speed of separation, whichever is applicable. Enough time, you got it. So are you getting zero? Yes, you are getting very, very, very good, wonderful. You got zero. Zero is your result. See, B is at rest. Sorry, B is here. A is at rest, A is fixed, B is moving on this circle like this. So the separation will remain constant and it will be equal to radius of the circle, right? So as B is moving on the circle and A is fixed, the separation between them, which in this case is equal to radius of the circle, remains constant. So speed of approach is zero, speed of separation is zero. The particles, they are neither approaching nor separating from each other, right? But dear students, focus. One more important thing. You think about this velocity. See, V vector is like this, and this angle is 90 degree. So what will be component of this V vector on line joining the two particles? See, because it is 90, so this component will be zero. So therefore, because component of V on this line is zero and this velocity is zero itself, so speed of approach is zero, right? So we can put it this way. It is very, very important. We can again see this situation. In other words, we can see this way. Component of velocity of B towards A is V cos 90, which is equal to zero. And A is at rest only, so speed of approach, speed of separation, both are equal to zero. Therefore, dear students, one point is there. What? As V is perpendicular to line joining the two particles, therefore V neither contributes for approach nor for separation. It is very simple but very, very important point. Right? So let us move forward. Few very important points are coming. Maintain focus. This one. There will be a little thinking exercise on your screen. Whatever is displayed, please do it. This is the case given. Particle A, particle B. Velocities are shown. V1, V2, theta 1, theta 2. Now you are getting some confidence in speed of approach and speed of separation. Let us attempt it. Whether this is case of speed of approach or of speed of separation, and is equal to what? Think. You got it. This is case of speed of approach. So for it, let us do this next figure. What we are doing? We are making components. V1 ka component, V1 cos theta 1, V1 sin theta 1. V2 ka component, V2 cos theta 2, V2 sin theta 2. Now these V1 sin theta 1 component and V2 sin theta 2 component, these two components are playing no role. Why they are not playing any role? Because these two components are perpendicular to line joining the two particles. Remember the previous case, the circle wala case, that V velocity was doing the same thing, right? So which component will be playing the role? Cos component. So this v1 cos theta 1 and v2 cos theta 2, and due to these two velocity components, the particles are approaching each other. Therefore, can we just say that speed of approach is v1 cos theta 1 plus v2 cos theta 2, right? You can also read these lines here. What is written is that these two components are not useful because they are perpendicular to line joining the two particles, right? So we need to look into it very fast. You can replay this video because time is running out. Basically, focus. Each and every point is very important. This case, you're getting the figure. Now you're gaining some confidence in speed of approach and speed of separation. What is it? This is it. This value, right? When we make components, cos component, sine component, when we make components, cos component, sine component, right? These two components are playing no role. Why? You tell. Because v1 sine theta 1 and v2 sine theta 2, these components are perpendicular to line joining the two particles. And due to these cos components, they are separating. Therefore, speed of separation is equal to v1 cos theta 1 plus v2 cos theta 2. अरे एक बात बताओ, यहाँ पे माइनस क्यों नहीं आया? एक माइनस लगा देते हैं ना यहाँ पे. नहीं लगा सकते, बिकॉज v1 cos theta 1 भी सेपरेशन में कंट्रीब्यूशन दे रहा है, v2 cos theta 2 भी सेपरेशन में कंट्रीब्यूशन दे रहा है. तो ओवरऑल स्पीड ऑफ सेपरेशन क्या हो जाएगी? v1 cos theta 1 प्लस v2 cos theta 2 ही होगी. ओके, डन. फोकस, स्पीड विल बी अ लिटिल हाई. फोकस डियर स्टूडेंट्स. Now let us think about this case. This is very, very important. Now in this case, speed of approach or speed of separation? See, in this case it depends now. We can see it with the help of components. If we make components, cos component, sine, so these two components are not playing any role. Now you very well know why they are not playing any role. V1 cos theta 1, V2 cos theta 2. So if this component dominates, then it will become a case of speed of approach. So if v1 cos theta 1 is greater than v2 cos theta 2, then speed of approach is equal to v1 cos theta 1 minus v2 cos theta 2. Similarly, if v2 cos theta 2 is more, then it will be case of separation. So v2 cos theta 2 more than v1 cos theta 1, speed of separation equal to v2 cos theta 2 minus v1 cos theta 1. And think, if both are same, v1 cos theta 1 equal to v2 cos theta 2, then it will be case of neither approach nor separation, right? Speed is little fast. You can rewind this video just in few seconds. See this case, particle A like this, particle B like this. You're getting this figure. Got this? Because you have got the complete concept. U is itself U. Done. Let us make components of this U, cos theta and sin theta component. Sin theta ko hata dete hain. U aur U cos theta hai, dono ko add kar dete hain. U plus U cos theta, speed of approach, right? Most important, dear students, it should be noted that speed of approach and speed of separation are instantaneous terms, as the very next moment situation or orientation may change and speed of approach and speed of separation may have new values. It is very simple. To understand this point, let us go back to the previous slide. See, in this case, it is case of speed of approach. But see, after a long time, this particle would be somewhere there, this particle would be somewhere there. So these two particles would be separating from each other after a long time. So speed of approach and speed of separation are what? Instantaneous terms, right? In coming slides, in coming videos, dear students, we are going to apply these concepts in problem solving. The problem solving is going to be very, very important, right? So follow the complete video chain to get a grip over what exactly IIT professors want. Happy learning, dear students.